We'd like to start the regular press conference by Minister MOTEGI. Minister, the floor is yours. We already had a media briefing last night. I did not have any opening statements. I'd be willing to take your questions. We'll take your questions now. If you have any question, please raise your hand. Please wait to be designated and use the microphone nearest to you. State your name and affiliation, and then go on to your question. Please, anyone with a question. Fukuda-san, please. Thank you. My name is Fukuda with Yomiura. Tomorrow, it will be 1 month after the new administration in the United States has taken office. In the meantime, in terms of security policy and also bilateral relations between Japan and the United States, what are your thoughts about the new administration in the United States? Well, thank you. The Biden administration will mark its 1 month anniversary, if you will, since taking office tomorrow. And immediately after the administration has taken office, at the leaders level as well as at the ministerial level, they have demonstrated a very strong commitment toward Japan-U.S. security alliance. Japan welcomes this. As for myself, and since the Biden, in the 1 month since the Biden administration has taken office, we have already had two phone conferences between myself and my counterpart. This is probably the most frequent. And also yesterday, we had Japan, Australia, India, U.S. phone ministerial conference. And I was able to have very close communication with Secretary Blinken. And I believe that we have been able to create coordination in responses to various issues as a result. In particular, immediately after the Biden administration has taken office, inclusive of a response toward the delivery of free and open Indo-Pacific, as well as a response to China, I believe that in terms of the basic direction toward response to various issues in the region, as well as in the international community, between myself and Secretary Blinken, we've been able to have very close coordination that I believe has been most meaningful. As far as the host nation support issue is concerned, this week we were able to come to an agreement. And in my first phone conference with Secretary Blinken, we confirmed the need for the conclusion of the negotiation. And subsequently, on February 17th, the current special agreement was revised, and we were able to come to an agreement on amended protocol, which extends the current period by 1 year. The fact that at a very early timing since the administration has taken office that we were able to come to an agreement really demonstrates the strong commitment of both countries toward the Japan-U.S. alliance, and also this will heighten the credibility of this alliance, and will communicate that to the international community. So we appreciate this. Going forward, between myself and Secretary Blinken, I would like to further strengthen our personal relationship of trust. We've been calling ourselves Tony and Tosh, and also with Mr. Lighthouser, it took a lot of time before we were able to come to reach a first name basis. But I want to further strengthen our personal sense of relationship of trust between myself and Mr. Blinken, and also toward the promotion of free and open in the Pacific, as well as toward the strengthening of the alliance further. Also, in terms of response to challenges pertaining to international communities such as COVID-19 response and climate change, I want to see coordination between Japan and the United States and lead to the international community. By the way, with regard to Mr. Lighthouser, we've had very tough negotiations, but we have a relationship based on trust, and ultimately, between Japan and the United States, we're able to reach a very good agreement. Thank you. That is all.
Next question, please. Ishinabe-san, please. Ishinabe from Sankei Shimbun. About the Hong Kong situation. In violation of national security law, Mr. Jimmy Lai, founder of Apple Daily, has been rearrested according to their report in Hong Kong. What do you think about this? The rearrest of Mr. Jimmy Lai and a series of events thus far. The basis of Hong Kong's development is freedom of speech and freedom of the press, which is the foundation of the development of Hong Kong, democratic and stable development. So we are very gravely concerned because of the impact. We are a very important, we consider Hong Kong to be a very important partner for us. So for Hong Kong to develop stably and democratically under one country, two systems, in a free system, is very important. That's been the consistent position of Japan. So this view of mine has been communicated to the Chinese side. The Japanese position has been conveyed to them. So we would like to coordinate with other relevant countries to appropriately address the situation. Next question, please.
Azuhari-san, please.
Mr. Azuhari, please.
Last week, sorry, Panorama News from Japan. Last week, Japan donated about $6 million to help the medical system in Syria. So that leads me to a question. What is the status of Japan-Syrian relations, and especially the status of the Japan embassy in Syria? Is it opened? Is it functioning well? Or do you have any plan to open it again? Thank you.
Thank you very much for your question. Thank you for the question. If we look back, well, Damascus in Syria in the medieval ages was the center of the Middle East. For example, the Crusades, during the era of the so-called Crusades, the Third Crusade, they had dominant power at that time. But the Islamic forces responded to this challenge. This actually started out in Damascus, and Arabir actually took creative forces in Alexandria. So this is a very core region of the Middle East. That is Damascus. So Damascus and Syria is now facing a very difficult situation. It will be 10 years since the Syrian crisis has taken place. And as the crisis in Syria has entered its 10th year, and the humanitarian and situation in Syria has not improved, and there is lack of progress in political process, we are concerned that the current situation has been fixated and the movement toward resolution has retreated. Japan, no matter what the circumstances are, have continued to implement humanitarian assistance to the people of Syria facing difficulties. And since 2012, to countries surrounding Syria as well as Syria, we've implemented $2.9 billion worth of assistance. And this time, we have decided upon additional assistance of $200 million anew. As far as Japan is concerned, through such humanitarian assistance, we want to improve the humanitarian situation within Syria and also under the United Nations in order to progress the political process to the resolution of the Syrian crisis. We want to maintain close coordination with the international community toward this end. And also, with regard to your question about the Japanese embassy in Syria, the temporary closing of the Japanese embassy in Syria is mainly due to the worsening of the local security situation. And decisions about reopening the operations of the embassy in Damascus will be made, bearing in mind careful monitoring of the local situation. We do not have any firm plans at this moment. Thank you.
Any other questions? If not, then this concludes the press conference. Thank you very much.